October 2nd, 1879, 21-year-old John Callahan stabbed a man to death at the Wayne County Fair. This resulted in the only execution in Wayne County history and Ohio's last death by hanging.
Stuff talk about George. Somebody said George was an inmate that hung himself here. Like I said, I come in the morning and I open up, so everything's locked up when I get here. And I came in the back door, come up into the kitchen, was turning the stuff on. I heard this bang upstairs in the banquet room. I thought, what the heck? It sounded like a table drop when you move the tables. So I'm like, okay, who could possibly be in here? And so I put my stuff down, I go upstairs, look around, there's nothing around. I'm like, okay, this is kind of spooky, but it's okay. So I go down the other steps, these front steps, check, I come clear down through here and up around, make a circle. I didn't see anybody. So I thought, okay, I'm just going to hang out for a minute. And I came back and go to the next building, and I heard the same thing. And it happened twice. And I was like, okay, this is not my imagination. This is definitely something banging on the floor up there. And I went back up, and I couldn't find anything. I mean, there was nobody in the building. It was locked up when I got here, so... That was my experience here at the old jail.
Because John Callahan was on death row, they kept him separate from the other inmates in the basement. This section of the fine dining area once held his cell.
It was late at night. We were closed in both restaurants. The managers were in the tavern. They were doing the closing stuff, counting money and so forth. And then the phone rang from downstairs in the basement of the jail. The manager went next door to see if anyone was there, and of course there was no one here. So after they thought it was a fluke, the phone system was new, so maybe it was just something with that. So they went back next door, and then it rang again. So then they went back downstairs. This time they took the money with them, went down to the lower office that was downstairs, and they were down there. They didn't see anyone. So they went down there, the phone rang in that office then, from the hostess station. So they all got kind of freaked out. They went next door. They grabbed three of the other managers that were there, and they all ran to throughout the building looking for someone. Of course, they found no one. So they went to, so they all pretty much got out of here.
When we were getting ready to open up, you know, cleaning up the place, getting ready to reopen after it had been closed down for about 6 months, things like soup bowls would just fly through the air. And we just felt like George was upset and wasn't sure, you know, what we were going to use the place for or whatever. But some other things happened, like hands flying next door. You know, you could hear it but not see anybody there. And I think he settled down eventually, though, because I think he likes what we did with the place.